Hi everyone, myself Supriya Apasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walden Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's session, we have the topic double shutter, fully panel door. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, student will be able to draw the neat drawings of different building components such as the door, window and the staircase. So out of this, I'm just going to tell you about the door. So this is the given data, the frame size, that is the window door opening, the size is given to you as 1000 mm by 2000 mm. Next is the post, that is 60 by 100 mm, top rail 100 by 35 mm, the frieze rail 100 by 35 mm, the lock rail 180 by 35 mm, and this is the bottom rail, that is 200 by 35 mm. And finally, we have the stiles, that is the vertical members, which are the called as the stiles, 100 by 35 mm. So these are the inputs of the door frame. So door frame, actually, it includes all the horizontal and the vertical members, which have the top horizontal members and the vertical members, bottom members. So according to the input given to us, that is the rails, you have actually the top rail and the bottom rail. And all the intermediate rails, they are called as the frieze rail. And lock rail is the arrangement of the lock, the locking arrangement where it is done, that is called as the lock rail. So these are the intermediate rails. So depending upon the input data given to us, we are going to decide how many panels are to be provided in the door. So as we have the top rail, the frieze rail, lock rail and the bottom rail, depending upon that, we have decided that it is a double shutter door and 6 panels are to be provided in this type of the door, as we have the lock rail and the frieze rail. Suppose the input would be given to you as top rail, the lock rail and the bottom rail. So in that case, we will be going for the 4 panel door, right? So depending upon the input given to us, we have decided that it is a 6 panel door and a double shutter is given to us. So actually for the doors, we have the head of the frame and the sill of the frame is also given to us. But in many of the doors, the sill is not provided in the doors. The sill is provided for the windows, and in the doors, the sill may be provided or may not be provided. So here we have the head of the frame, that is the topmost member of the frame. So as with the clear opening of the frame is given to you as 1000 mm by 2000 mm. That is, it is 1 meter. And if you convert it into meter, it is a 1 meter by 2 meter height. 1 meter is the width of the opening, that is the clear opening of the frame. And this is the height of the frame, which includes the head of the frame also in that. So here, we didn't consider the sill of the door. So directly on the floor level itself, the door is fixed. So here you can see that the door, it is not inserted immediately. So a gap of 6 mm is left on the top of the floor, so that the doors can be easily closed and opened when they are fitted. So next you have the head of the frame. So the head of the frame, the size is given to you as 60 by 100 mm. So 60 is the height of the door and the 100 mm will be the thickness of the door, which will be seen in the section when you take it. So now just I am going to explain you the elevation of the door, that is the plan of the door. So next, these are the projections. You can see the projections which are taken outside over here. That is, it is called as the horn. So there, this projection, it is the horizontal projections which is provided in the top and the, that is the head of the frame and the sill of the frame also. So this projection, it is around 15 centimeter. So these horizontal projections, they are taken outside so that it will be embedded into the side walls so that the frame can be fixed over there, right? So next we have the hold fast. These are the hold fast which are provided 3 on each side. So for the door, actually the hold fast, they are total 6 in number, whereas for the windows there are 4 in number. So the hold fast, they are made up of the mild steel flat bars. They are of a section 30 mm by 6 mm and of length 20 cm. So they are fixed they are in bent up at the right angles to each other. That is, one end of it is connected to the vertical member and the other end it is embedded into the wall. So next you have the top member, it was the head of the frame. And to the side here, you can see this is the post. The post size is given to you as 60 by 100 mm. So take the width as 60 mm over here, and the thickness will be 100 mm, which will be seen in the section. So overall now, the frame thickness, the frame which you have, the overall thickness of the frame is 60 mm. Here the head wall, header, there we have shown the head of the frame, that is 60 mm height, and this is the width, that is the post width, it is shown as 60 mm. So overall now we have fixed the frame size. So now next data, we have the top rail, and before that we have to see whether the any vertical member is given to us. So in that, the vertical member is the style. These are the styles which are provided at the outermost, that is the outside of the frame. This is the outside of the frame, that is the styles. Here you have to take the dimension as 100 mm by 35 mm. So 100 mm is the width of the style. This is the width of the style, which has to be taken from this dotted portion. The dotted portion, it is called as the ribbed. From that dotted line itself, you have to take the measurement as 100 mm. And take the vertical line, that is the vertical member, which is called as the styles. So on both the sides, that is the left and the right side, you have to take the vertical member, which is called as the style. So this dimension, the width of the style is 100 mm, and 35 mm will be the width of the style. So before that, just I will tell you about the scale what I have taken. The scale is 1:10. That means if suppose you have the dimensions in meter, that is 1 meter by 2 meter size. So you have to first of all convert that meter into centimeter. So 1 meter into 100 multiplied by 100, you convert it into centimeter. So 100 centimeter, and divided by the scale, that is 10. So you get 10 centimeter. So this is how the scale has been converted. So likewise, you have to draft it by the mini drafter. Now I have shown you the pick only. So but while drawing, you have to use the mini drafter, as you will get more fluency in that. So next, you have the next dimension, that is the vertical members you have drawn, that is the styles. And in the middle, now after drawing the vertical member styles and the post, just measure the distance from this corner to this corner, this one, two corners of the, just count the remaining distance, how much it is. And then take the center, mark the center point of that, and then the vertical line is drawn. And beside that, you have to draw the dotted line, which is called as the ribbed line. Ribbed is nothing but a depression which is made of 12 mm wide, and the depth of that will be the same as the thickness of the shutter you have. So just the dotted portion is shown throughout the frame. On one side it is shown. This is the dotted line, which is called as the ribbed. So from that dotted line itself, you have to count 100 mm distance and mark over here. And then from the dark line which you have drawn, from that you have to measure 100 mm and mark the other point, that is two vertical lines you get. So these the remaining the member which are shown in the vertical lines, that are called as the meeting styles. As they are meeting one another, they are called as the meeting styles, so that both the shutters can be closed easily. Next, after that, you have to see what the top rail dimension is given to us. So the top rail dimension is given to us as 100 by 35 mm. So 100 is the height of the rail and 35 is the thickness. So from top of this, that is the below head of the frame, you take the width as 100 mm and mark this point, so that you get the top rail dimension, that is the width of the top rail as 100 mm. And then draw this line, just mark the top rail dimension, and after that you have to mark the bottom rail dimension. That is, first of all, take the distance from the top rail and the bottom rail. The bottom rail dimension is given to you as 200 by 35 mm. So take this height as 200 mm. So likewise, just you have plotted only two lines, that is the topmost and the bottommost line you have drawn. So now you have to insert the lock rail. The size of the panel is not given to you, but the thickness of the panel is given to you as 3 mm. This is the thickness what is given to you. The thickness of the panel is given to us, that is 3 mm. So before that, just try to insert the locking arrangement over here. So for that, I have taken the dimension as, from the floor level itself, I have taken as 800 mm and marked this point. This point I have marked, so that this is the overall height of the first panel, right? So the height of the panel is not given to us. So you can vary the height of the panel, or else you can keep the size of the panel equal in all the panels, all the six panels. You can keep the height of the panel same. It depends upon the architectural view and all. Okay, so just I have taken the dimension as 800 mm from the floor level itself and marked this point so that I have got the height of the panel over here. So then after that, the locking arrangement I have found, the locking arrangement size is given to you as 180 by 35 mm. So from this point itself, 180, that is 180 I have marked, that is 1.8 centimeter, and then drawn the horizontal line, and then I have calculated the distance, how much is this from the top rail to the lock rail. So you divide it into two parts. I have taken the center line of that, and from that the freeze rail dimension is fixed, that is 100 mm by 35 mm. So likewise, these are the panels which have been drawn. So the locking arrangement which shall be provided in the lock rail itself, so that it can be easily reached at a desired level height of the person. So this is the locking arrangement which is provided. So this is what the front elevation of a fully panel door is. So all these dimensions, they are in mm, and the scale is 1:10. So here are the MCQs given. The middle horizontal member of the shutter is called dash. First is the median rail, second is the mid rail, third is the sill rail, fourth is the lock rail. Hope so you have got the answer for this. This is the answer for that. Next, which of the below doors is generally used in the residential and the office buildings? First is the flush door, second is the rotating door, third is the levered door, fourth is the hinged door. Hope so you have got the answer for this. Yes, flush door is the right answer. These are the references. Thank you.